Hey guys, do you want your YouTube traffic sources to look something like this? In this video, I'm going to show you how to get more suggested video views to your channel. And the first thing that you have to do is you have to do what others don't. If you want to be successful, you have to be willing to grow organically. So right now, commit to grow 100% organically on YouTube. And what this means is you have to not take any shortcuts. See, the thing is I think a lot of new YouTubers forget that YouTube can see everything that you're doing on the platform. YouTube can see if you're engaging in sub for sub. It can see if you're trading views. It notices if you're making fake YouTube accounts and watching your own videos. So don't try to game the system. If you want more suggested video views, then you need to play by the rules. And if you do that, then you are setting yourself up to get those suggested video views, even as a new YouTuber. So my next tip for you is don't share your videos. Personally, I don't share my videos at all anymore, and I wish I never would have. But if you still want to share your videos, then wait at least 72 hours before doing so. Now the reason for this is in the first 24 to 48 hours, YouTube starts to suggest your video if you don't share it at all in order to test your video. And so if you allow YouTube to do that, then you will get those suggested video views. And then once it starts to slow down, if you want to share your video on social media in order to give it a second boost, then that's your decision. But I would at least wait until you give YouTube a chance to test out your content. And now you might be thinking, well, what about view velocity? And true, view velocity can help a video be more successful. If a video gets a lot of views right when it's released, then this sends signals to the algorithm and might get your video boosted out to more people. But here's the thing, and here's my next tip, is you need to change the way that you think about views. So a view, according to YouTube, is defined as somebody watching your video for at least 30 seconds. And in my terms, if somebody watches only 30 seconds of a video, then that video is a failure. And so change the goal that you have and don't think about getting more views, think about getting better views. The way that you judge your views on your channel is to look at your audience retention graphs and your average view duration. If you are getting a high audience retention score, then you are getting high quality views. Because essentially there's two types of views you can get. There's a quick view, which is bad. You don't want those, where somebody only watches your video for 30 seconds. And then there are high quality views where you're keeping your viewers on the video. And if you keep them on the video, then you will get more suggested video views. So my next tip for you is, especially as a new YouTuber, don't focus on views and subscribers, and instead focus on average view duration, engagement, and click-through rate. If you focus on these three metrics, you will get a lot more suggested video views, which will help your channel grow. So the first, average view duration, is how long people on average are watching your video. The higher that amount of time, the more suggested video views you will get because you are keeping people on the platform. Now, if your videos also get a lot of engagement, such as likes, dislikes, comments, all that kind of stuff, then that's keeping people also on the platform, which means YouTube will also suggest the video. Now, the last thing is you need to make sure that your impressions click-through rate is high enough that YouTube has a reason to suggest your video. Basically, if your thumbnail is not clickable, then YouTube will not suggest your video because even if they suggest it, nobody's going to click on it. So it is worth to put in the effort to make a clickable thumbnail because then you're making your video more suggestible for YouTube so that you can get those views. So my next tip for you is to try to make 10-minute videos. Now, I know not every content type fits well into a 10-minute video. And there are definitely exceptions to the goal of 10 minutes as being the best length for YouTube. But in general, if you can plan your video around the goal of filling 10 minutes, then you are optimizing for search and suggested. So what you gotta do is plan enough bullet points in your video so that it is most likely going to be 10 minutes once you are done with your editing. And so I always try to plan my videos to be 10 minutes, but they don't always turn out to be 10 minutes, and that's okay. As long as you are effectively conveying your message to your viewers, then that's really all that matters. But the reason a 10-minute video is ideal for YouTube is if you make a 10-minute video and it has a high audience retention rate, then people are going to stay on that video for at least 5 minutes or half the video, which will prolong people's viewing sessions on YouTube, which is the goal of YouTube. So if you make 10-minute videos, you are making your videos more suggestible for YouTube, which will get you more of those suggested video views that you're after. Now, my next tip for you is one that most new YouTubers forget all about, and I include myself in this, and it is to plan a hook at the beginning of your video. Now, as you saw in this video, before I even started, I said, do you want your traffic sources to look like this? And I showed you my traffic sources, and this was the hook for the video. I was basically showing you that I'm getting a lot of suggested traffic, and this is how I get it. So I'm showing you my results, which gives you a proof of concept and makes you want to watch the video. So if you can use a hook to engage your viewers, then you'll be a lot more likely to get more suggested video views because your audience retention rate will be higher. See, if you look at your audience retention graphs, if your video dips out immediately in the beginning of the graph, then that means that there wasn't an effective hook because people didn't feel a need to stay on the video. You weren't engaging their interest. So if you plan a hook, your audience retention will skyrocket and then your videos will be a lot more suggestible. My next tip for you is to keep your SEO as simple as possible. Now, SEO refers to search engine optimization, and that's basically optimizing for YouTube search. And what you gotta do to make your SEO work is you basically need to build your whole video and every aspect of your video around one specific keyword, and then to make it blatantly obvious to YouTube which keyword you're targeting. Basically, in this video, I'm targeting how to get more suggested video views. So my video file is named how to get more suggested video views, and so is the thumbnail file. And the first keyword in my description box is how to get more suggested video views. And my title is how to get more suggested video views. And guess what? That's the same tag that's in my tag box, how to get more suggested video views. And by doing all these things and by using that phrase in my video, then I'm telling the YouTube search engine exactly what my video is about so that YouTube will know where to rank it in search, but also who to suggest the video to, because it will suggest to viewers that want more suggested video views, because that's what my video is actually about. So you don't have to be an expert in SEO. You just need to make sure that you tell the search engine exactly what your video is about so you can get those suggested views. Now, another important tip that you probably weren't thinking about is you need to plan a hook at the end of your video. See, your video needs two hooks. The first is the one that hooks the viewers into the video, and then the next hook at the end needs to be the one that hooks viewers into watching the next video. Because see, YouTube doesn't want people to watch just one video, it wants them to watch video after video after video. So what you gotta do is start talking about one of your other videos at the end of your video. So for example, I made a video on how to get your videos suggested by YouTube in 2020. And at the end of this video, I will link that video because the video is very engaging and will help people get the results that they are after. See, the video is made with a program called VideoScribe, which animates the video, so it's very engaging. And then the video is packed with tips of actual actionable steps that you can take to get your videos suggested by YouTube. See, here's the thing. New YouTubers, they get frustrated because they don't know what to do to get their videos suggested. And they're watching videos, and all these videos are filled with complex concepts that make it confusing and frustrating, when really it's just a couple specific things that you need to do on a consistent basis to set up your video to be suggestible. So in that video, I will share with you all of the actionable steps that you need to take in order to get more suggested traffic to your channel. And if you found this video to be helpful, please consider subscribing so that I can help you get more subscribers on YouTube.